Hello, I'm Tristan from Smart Home Point. Did you know that if you go out and you buy random smart lights from Amazon every single time there's a sale, you will end up like this?
Why do I have 12 different apps to control my smart home?
Or you'll walk into a room and ask yourself,
how do I turn that light on again?
This is a common but serious affliction known as SHC, smart home confusion. Buying smart devices from loads of different companies isn't too bad if it's spread around your home. For example, MyQ to use your garage door, Amazon Echo for your voice speakers, and then EcoBee for your smart thermostat. But it is a problem if your smart lights themselves are all from different companies. This is because even if they're all compatible with Echo devices, for example, you still need to remember the exact name of each and every light bulb in order to control them. Or you need to remember which app on your phone to launch. Plus, it's pretty rubbish to have to pull out your smartphone every single time you want to control your smart lights, in my opinion. So, when choosing smart lighting for your home, there's a few crucial factors to consider, which this video explores in detail. Firstly, are the lights themselves high-quality RGB CCT or just RGB? Secondly, if you do mix and match lights from loads of different companies, will they be colour compatible with each other? Thirdly, can you control your lights with buttons and remotes and motion sensors, or only with your voice and a smartphone? Fourthly, you need to consider whether they are Wi-Fi or ZigBee based. Will you need to buy an expensive lighting hub to control your lights, for example? Finally, will your lights support the new chip, weight, matter standard? If that all sounds like complete gibberish, worry not, because I'll cover all of this in today's video, and in an easy to understand way, hopefully. Right, factor one, the LEDs. Smart lights are made up of multiple light-emitting diodes, LEDs. At a minimum, a full-colour smart light will have three LEDs, red, green, and blue. This means that if you want to set your lights to bright orange or mauve, the three colour LEDs will mix and match the colours as needed to display your chosen light colour. Side note, does anyone else think the mauve is a really stupid name for a colour? Just me? Okay, cool. So, a smart light with RGB diodes is good, but they do have one particular issue, white light. It's quite common to want a light to display white light, whether that's bluey white light for sort of daytime or yellowy white for nighttime. However, with just red, green and blue diodes, it's hard, if not impossible, to actually achieve proper white light. As a result, higher end and higher quality smart lighting providers such as LifeX and Philips Hue actually introduce extra white diodes. Sometimes this is a single warm white diode, sometimes it's a single cool white diode, while sometimes they actually have both, resulting in five diodes: red, green, blue, warm white and cool white. This then allows the bulb to deliver really realistic looking colours and also white light. But this then throws up another point of confusion: how both the colours and the whites should be controlled. Sometimes they can be controlled within the app on your phone by having two different wheels, one for the sort of colour temperature, the white light, and one for the actual RGB colours. But this is a bit clunky, and so the higher end smart lighting providers actually offer something better, known as RGB CCT. This merges the colour temperature and the RGB control into one, meaning in practical terms you'll just have a single control wheel within the app. This is the most convenient option by far, but it'll also work out more expensive than simply going out and buying a budget full colour smart bulb. The second factor to consider is actually whether you should mix different lights from different companies. And the short answer here is no, you probably shouldn't. The reason for that is that every single light and light bulb produced by a different company will have slightly different components and slightly different diodes. It will also have slightly different software. What that all means is that the light themselves will produce slightly different colours, slightly different white lights, and it's really, really difficult to get everything compatible. So, for example, if in your living room you've got four spotlights and they're all from different companies, if you went and said set them all to purple, they will all look slightly different. Some people wouldn't care about that, but I think the average smart home user would care about that. They would notice the difference. What they would also notice is that actually transitions between different colours and different brightnesses will also be different between each bulb, and that can be really annoying. So if you're considering going out in Amazon sales and just buying loads of different light bulbs, that's usually not a very good idea. It's best to stick to one company for your smart lights, at least for a single room. Of course, you might not always want to go out and spend $50 on a Philips Hue or LifeX full RGB bulb. That might not always be practical, especially if you're putting them in a basement or utility room where you don't spend much time. As a result, what you could potentially do is make sure that you've got Philips Hue bulbs, for example, in your living room, and then in another room of your house, you have a more budget make. In that way, even though the colours will be incompatible, you won't actually know because you'll be in a different room of your house. So that can be one way of actually mixing lights from different companies in a way that doesn't actually impact you and doesn't actually stick out like a sore thumb. The third factor to consider is how you actually control your light bulbs. This might not seem like an important factor because many bulbs on Amazon say that they support Google Home and Alexa, which might make you think that you can just go out and control all your bulbs with your voice on your Amazon Echo device or a Google Home device. But the flaw with this is that that requires you to actually remember the exact name of every single light bulb in your house in order to control them. In reality, this isn't always practical, especially with Amazon Echo devices where it's really, really picky about the name that you give to a bulb. If you get it slightly wrong, it'll come back and say things like, a few things share the name utility room, which one did you mean? As a result, you'll probably want to throw your Amazon Echo device out the window because it's really annoying if you go into your utility room with an arm full of clothes, the light's off, and you're issuing voice commands to try and turn the light on, and your Amazon Echo device just keeps saying, which light did you mean? It's just not practical. It just doesn't work very well. The other alternative, like I mentioned in my introduction, is to pull out your smartphone. But then, of course, you have to remember which app is corresponding to which light. For example, if you've got 10 different smartphone apps because you've got lights from 10 different providers, you need to remember which ceiling light, for example, corresponds to which app, and that's not practical. So the method that I prefer is to actually use something like Philips Hue, which comes with a range of accessories to actually control your smart lights. So for example, you've got a dimmer switch, you've got a motion sensor, and you can configure all these to actually control one light or a group of light or even your whole house if you wanted. And that can be really practical because although smart lighting would imply that you will control everything with your voice or with an app, sometimes you do simply want to control things with a physical device instead. And I actually find that this is the best option overall. The next thing that you will want to consider for your smart lighting platform is whether they should be controlled with Wi-Fi or ZigBee. I know this doesn't sound like a very important topic, but actually it sort of is. Many bulbs which are Wi-Fi controlled, like my LifeX one in the ceiling, they don't require an external hub. They connect directly to your internet router, and then you can obviously connect to them with your smartphone, which will also be on your Wi-Fi network, and you can control them in that way. That's really convenient, but many internet routers have been built to support 10 to 20 devices, connected Wi-Fi devices. As a result, if you go around your house buying loads of Wi-Fi connected bulbs, you might find that all of a sudden your internet router starts crashing or having loads of issues or even booting your phone off the network because there's simply too many Wi-Fi connected devices, and that's often no good. As a result, sometimes it's nicer to offload all your lights and have them connect to something else known as a smart hub. Philips Hue, for example, who I mentioned earlier, they actually, all your Philips Hue lights, such as a light strip or a ceiling bulb, they connect to a Hue hub, or a Hue bridge as it's sometimes called. This speaks ZigBee. Now, don't worry about that too much, but basically it's quite similar to Wi-Fi. The nice thing with this is that all your lights then connect to the Philips Hue bridge or hub. That supports up to 50 lights, which is enough for the vast majority of homes. And as a result, they save your Wi-Fi network, they save your internet router, because you're not going to overload your internet router with all your lights connecting to it. Of course, the one downside here, if you do go down the ZigBee route, is that you need to go out and buy a Philips Hue bridge. By itself, this can be up to $50, although usually you can get it a bit cheaper as part of a starter kit. But of course, this is an added expense that you don't need with a Wi-Fi bulb. With a Wi-Fi bulb, you simply buy it and it just works. With that being said, one nice thing that Amazon have recently done is their more recent versions of the Echo devices actually contain a little ZigBee chip. And what that means is that your ZigBee-based lights, such as from Philips Hue, Gladopto, Sylvania, Inner, they can connect directly to your Amazon Echo device, and that acts as a sort of smart hub. The benefit of that is then you don't need to go out and buy a Philips Hue hub, and that saves you money. Of course, the downside is it's not always clear which Echo device actually contains a ZigBee chip. I'll put details on the screen now, but the short of it is the Echo Show 5 and 8 do not contain a ZigBee chip, and an Echo Dot device also doesn't contain a ZigBee chip. It's usually the full-size and more expensive Echo devices that do contain this ZigBee chip. Now, if you do go down this route, that's great because you've saved money on the Hue Bridge, but you need to understand that you then won't be able to use the full feature set available with Philips Hue lights. For example, with Philips Hue lights, you can do a color loop, which you're seeing at the moment. You can do home and away control and a whole range of other things. But if you connect your Philips Hue light strips and bulbs directly to your Echo device, you won't be able to use those features. You're more limited. You can change color, you can dim things, you can turn it on and off. But beyond that, you are more limited. Equally, the Hue accessories, as they're called, some of these, or many of these, don't actually work with the Amazon Echo devices. For example, the motion sensor requires the Philips Hue bridge. So if you go down the route of Philips Hue, but then you use your Echo device to save money and not have a Hue bridge, you've got to accept that you won't actually be able to use the full feature set of Philips Hue software and also the actual accessories as well. So that's a bit of a downside. If it's me, if I've weighed up all the options and I don't want a Wi-Fi based smart lighting system because I don't want to overload my internet router, I would then personally just go out and buy a Philips Hue starter kit to get the bridge and a few light bulbs as part of that. I think that's probably the most cost effective way forward if you do decide that ZigBee is the right way to go for your smart lighting solution. The fifth and final factor that I will discuss today is future-proofing. This is quite an important topic at the moment in the smart home industry because loads of different smart home devices are not compatible with each other. For example, if you've got a smart doorbell from Ring, you can't really control that very easily with your Google Home device. You can only control it with your Amazon Echo devices. Equally, some smart lights work perfectly well with Amazon Echo, but they don't work with Google Home or Google Nest or whatever they're called. As a result of that, a year or two ago, a project called Connected Home over IP got announced, and basically loads of different smart home companies, including Apple with HomeKit support, they came together and they said, hey, let's create a standard to actually allow all these different smart devices to speak in a common way. That's a really nice idea. Although I will point out it's now been renamed to Matter. Ignoring the fact that I think that Matter is a slightly stupid name, the whole movement, the whole idea behind chip or Matter is quite a good one. It means that your smart lighting platform, or your smart lighting ecosystem, should be controllable from loads of different smart devices in the future. For example, even if your smart light at the moment is only controllable from Amazon Echo, it might be in the future that it can now be controlled from Google Nest Mini devices as well, for example. But the one thing you need to consider is whether your light bulbs will actually be Matter compatible. If they're not, then you could have spent potentially thousands of dollars on your smart lighting platform, only to find that it's controllable via a single app on your phone in the future, and you can't control it from loads of different other smart devices. This is where I, again, like Philips Hue. They recently announced, as you can see from this tweet, from the Philips Hue head of technology, the Hue Bridge will support Matter. What this means is that if you've gone out and invested in a Philips Hue bridge, then in the future that will just have a software update and make it Matter compatible. And then any voice speakers or third-party remote controls, they should, as long as they are Matter compatible in the future as well, they can all of a sudden start controlling your Philips Hue lights. This is a big deal because if your smart lights themselves are Matter compatible, then there might be a time in 3 or 4 years in the future whereby a company come out and they produce some super duper smart lighting remote control that could be Matter compatible, and then all of a sudden you will be able to buy that and use that to control your entire smart lighting system in your house, which is something that isn't really possible right now unless you use ZigBee in some ways. But in general, you probably want to make sure that your smart lighting system is Matter compatible or will be in the future. Right now, Philips Hue are one of the only ones who have come out and said, yes, they will be. I personally doubt that any budget smart lighting bulbs on Amazon right now will turn out to be Matter compatible in the future. I doubt that they're going to be able to do a software update and make it Matter compatible. As a result of that, You want to make sure, before investing thousands of dollars in your smart lighting ecosystem, you want to make sure that it is Matter compatible, or it will be in the future. As a result of that, for me personally, if I'm going to go out and buy a brand new smart lighting system, I will go with Philips Hue. That's because their bulbs are RGB CCT, which are probably some of the best. They can be controlled with loads of different remotes and accessories and things like that. And we know they will be Matter compatible. So for me personally, Philips Hue at the moment is probably the best system to actually go out and buy. But if you don't actually want to spend, as I mentioned earlier, $50 on some really expensive light bulb in a room that you're not going to go into, the nice thing with Philips Hue is that as long as you've got the bridge, that speaks ZigBee. So you can go out and buy a cheaper make such as Gladopto or Sylvania. They will be ZigBee compatible. What that means is that you can actually add those cheaper bulbs to your Hue bridge. You can control them with Hue accessories, and you can control them with the Hue app. You can put those in different rooms in your houses. Just make sure you group them for color compatibility, and that will work just fine as well. So for me personally, the Philips Hue ecosystem, which also includes Gladopto, Sylvania, Inner, and a bunch of other makes, that is probably the best smart lighting system to go with, especially since it's future-proofed because of its Matter support. I hope that all makes sense. If you've got any questions though, please do leave a comment and I will get back to you as soon as I can. I hope this video has been helpful to you. If it has, please click the thumbs up button, which will tell YouTube that more people should watch this video. Please also consider subscribing to my channel and clicking the little bell icon to be notified of all my future videos. Thank you.